3210 is a continuous intake course, which means that you can be starting this course at a different time from everyone else. Now, your start date will be the first Monday following your week of your registration. Okay, so if you registered on a Thursday, the following Monday is your week one. It's really important that you remember that and you make a note of those dates, because you've got 10 weeks to complete the course. A week within the course is usually from Monday to Sunday night at 11:59. Now, this checklist that we have provided here is intended to give you a structure and guide you through a submission process that will benefit you. One of the most important things that we have learned through the research is that feedback in a structured environment and from a trusted guide or mentor is one of the most important things that can contribute to achievement. Now, my job is to help you be successful, so I want to be able to give you feedback on your assignments as soon as you submit them. So while you do have total control of your schedule and you can submit your assignments at the very, very end and they won't be considered late, what will happen is you won't get the feedback that you should be using to improve your work. Remember, you're developing your own course and curriculum and supporting documents, and so you're going to want to do as good a job as possible, so you're going to want to take the feedback that I can provide. So if you do want to follow along on that schedule, we've got some dates here, weeks 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and so on and so forth. And you'll see here that green starts, the green indicates when you want to start your assignments, and again, we're recommending this. We encourage you to contact us, and we encourage you to do that on the second week, but you can reach out on the first week to set up a time to meet. But in the second week, you already have to submit your first reflective entry. And that is if you want to receive feedback. If you submit this entry in week three, well, I'll grade it and you'll get full marks for it, but you won't get the feedback that you can use to make adjustments. It's really important that you submit your assignments on these staggered times so that you can get the feedback. So follow along. You know, you've got the second reflective assignment that starts in week three. In week four, this is when you want to submit both your course profile, part A and part B, That's the main focus of the course, and I can give you feedback on that, and then you can make that adjustment, and you'll notice that you've got an extra 5% here that happens at the end when you submit the reflection on your course profile. All you have to do is simply submit the changes you've made, resubmit, and I don't reassess it. You simply get credit for resubmitting, for indicating to me that you've actually done the work. Okay, so the reflection component is extremely important. So you've got reflective writing assignments, you've got your lesson plan assignment at a certain time in week six, and then you've got your course outline part A and B in week nine. So ideally you want to follow this schedule if you want to get and maximize the feedback that I can give you to help you to improve. Because remember, my job is to help you be successful. Now, you're a professional, you're an adult, you can control your time. So these dates are for our recommendation on the best way to proceed through the course and not get overwhelmed. But again, you do have control of your time. So again, utilize this tool. Don't forget to change the X's into the actual dates when you begin. One more really important date, if a situation comes up, the final time to add or drop the course, if life happens and you run into difficulty, is week six. So if you're running into challenges and you need to withdraw, week six is that important deadline. So take a look at this document here. We've built this checklist for your benefit, and take advantage of it and use the staggered dates to receive the feedback that you can use to continue to improve and do the best possible job in creating your course curriculum.